it's really a, you know, a working man's amp.
It is the cutting edge of what we can do technology-wise and flexibility-wise.
It was a fairly obvious choice to work with Reinhold. He has somewhat of a history with Line 6 as it is, in that we've been working with the Spider Valve series and even some of the work we did with Alchemist. So we had already had a working relationship with Reinhold. He had ideas that he wanted to pursue to kind of give us more control of the amplifier.
The main attraction of this project was like that, you know, the tremendous flexibility that we can achieve with this kind of technology.
Instantly, the first things that we wanted to do right off the bat were to have the power amp section dynamically change, right, when you called up an amp model. Because in a physical amplifier, a lot of the tone comes from the interaction of the actual physical speaker and the actual physical power amp, right? And so we didn't want to shunt that in any way. We wanted to try and encourage that to happen.
The DT50 changes its analog section a lot. There's a lot of different little controls that we have.
Other amps have been able to change class AAB and do other kind of topology shifts to the amplifier. But I don't think anyone's ever done anything like this, where we've been able to dynamically change them to digitally control analog components in this way, so that we could completely reconfigure all these aspects of the actual analog hardware of the amp. And Reinhold did a phenomenal job of giving us this flexibility and at the same time just making the amp extremely toneful.
One of the big switches on it, you'll see a topology switch that says 1, 2, 3, 4. What that's actually changing is the feedback topology.
The feedback topology is it's a very cool thing to change, because it really affects the sound of your tube distortion. It affects how much gain you have, how much the speaker is sort of ringing, because it's providing this feedback loop that is either clamping that down or letting it run free. And with these sorts of things, even though you've only got one type of tube in your amp, you're getting a bunch of different sounds out of those same tubes. So it's very much like having multiple amplifiers inside this one case.
It occurs like any other guitar amp. It doesn't occur like a technologically difficult amp. There's many amps on the market that do this analog switching that you kind of look at the faceplate and your eyes start to glaze over. And I think the way we've executed it and the way that we've implemented the UI makes it occur very traditionally as a two-channel amp.
It can do what you need right out of the box by itself. You don't need any special pedal board. You just use an A-B switch between those two channels, and you're going to be thrilled.
As fun as it is to switch between Class A and Class A-B, the sonic difference of the different feedback topologies is just amazing. It feels entirely different every time you throw that switch.
So it should be a big milestone in, like, where, you know, like, technology can take us in the guitar field.